You've just learned that the person you love, that the person you are in love with, has cheated on you. Maybe it's your boyfriend or a girlfriend, or maybe it's your husband or a wife. Everyone you know, your friends, your relatives, everyone agrees. And you also believe that the right way to handle the situation is to break up as soon as possible and move on without looking back. However, it's not as easy to do as it sounds. You still love that person, and the fact that they cheated on you does not change all the good things that you guys had. You may have stopped talking to each other because of this cheating situation, but you miss them, you want to see them, you want to spend time with them. So, the question is this: is breaking up always the right solution to being cheated on? Under the risk of sounding a bit controversial, I would suggest that not all infidelity is equal. Not every situation where you're being cheated on is the same, and you should not be treating it as the same. It really depends on your specific and unique circumstances. Why did that other person cheat on you? How many times did they cheat on you? There's a lot of other factors that come into play. Some of the questions that you should be asking yourself and the person who cheated on you is, did they cheat out of anger? Did they cheat because they were intoxicated? Or did they fall in love with someone else? Of course, if that other person who you love developed feelings for someone else, then there's no point in continuing your relationship. You must move on. You have no choice. On the other hand, if you had a terrible fight, if you told some nasty things to your partner and out of spite and out of anger, they lost it and they went and slept with someone random, still a terrible situation, suggests some instability on the part of your partner, but it's not quite the same. There might be space there for discussion, space for working together toward forgiveness and toward trying to move past that. I could hear how some guys would say, oh, you're being a beta, you suggest that people put up with being cheated on. That's not what I'm saying. What I'm saying is that you should take the unique circumstances of a specific instance of a specific infidelity in consideration, and you should not paint every situation with the same brush. Some of the other questions you could ask: was it once, or was it more than once? If somebody made a mistake which they regret genuinely and they profess to you their love, they tell you how much they care about you, then at least you should consider forgiving if you also care about that person, if you're truly in love and you have a lot of good things going on. Now, like with anything else, getting over infidelity, getting over that pain and that anger takes time. You cannot expect to forgive the person who cheated on you overnight. It might take weeks, it might take months, it might even take longer in order to regain the trust and get over it. But time heals most things, and time heals this pain that comes with infidelity. And if you do get over it, often this type of situation, this type of conflict can even bring you closer together. So what am I trying to say? I'm not trying to say that you should forgive every time somebody cheats on you and that you should always give a second chance. No, what I'm saying is you should consider the situation you're in. You should listen to the other person. You should encourage them to be open and honest with you and tell you why they cheated on you. What happened? Do they regret it? Can they promise that it will never happen again? And then go from there. You don't have to make a decision right away. Oh, I was cheated on, it's over. If you really care, if you love that person, if you have a strong connection, if you have great chemistry, it's at least worth a shot considering whether there is space for forgiveness and space over getting over the challenge and moving on as a couple forward. Thank you.